So today's problem is called sum of root to leaf binary numbers. So given a binary tree, each node has value 0 or 1, so it will only be 0 and 1. Then each root to leaf path represents a binary number starting with the most significant bit. For example, if path is 01101, then this could represent 01101 in binary, which is 13. For all leaves in the tree, consider the numbers represented by the path from the root to that leaf. Leaf, return the sum of these numbers. Okay, so let's look at the example. So suppose you are looking at this tree. If you look at this leaf, what is the path? It is 100. 100 is 4. So this node will be holding a number 4. If you look at 101, which is 5, so 4 plus 5, 9. If you look at this one, 110, which is 6, so 4, 5, and 6 will be 15. And then 111 is 7, so 4, 5 plus 6 plus 7 is 22. So that's why answer for this problem will be 22. So how do we solve this? It is actually, if you know how to traverse tree, then you just need to somehow remember what is the path from the root to a leaf node, right? So let's try to just write the traversal first, and let's see if you are able to see what all leaf nodes are. All right, so we'll start with that, and then we will see what we can do. So if you look at this tree, it is the same tree which is given in the question. So let's try this. DFS, I will just do a normal traversal, which will be DFS, in which I'll go to a node and then I will recursively call its left and right child. So DFS root . So how do I do it is, if I have reached somewhere where there is no node, then I can just return. So basically, if you go from 1 to 0 and from 0 to 0, now after 0 nothing is there. So if I call that function after 0, then it should just return and do nothing. How do I find out if I am a leaf? So leaf will not have any children. So left will be null and right will also be null. Then I will just print it. Right, so node, I'll just print node for now. And let me also print root so that we know how it is being printed. So when I'm at a node, I'll print its value if it is a leaf. But if I'm at a node which is not a leaf, for example this one, then what do is I just try to go to its left child and I try to DFS on its right child as well. So I just do this. And DFS. That's it. So that is what I do. So let's just try to run this code. It should print. So how will it work is, because we are going to the left node first, so it will start at 1. Now, this is not a leaf node, so it will not print anything. It will go to the left node first. So we are at the execution of this one, we go to left. This is also not a leaf, we go to left. So this is a leaf node. Now it will actually, okay. So now it will print 0 and then it will go to its left, which is null. So it will just return. It will do nothing. Then we are back by recursion. We are back at 0. And then it will go to the right child, which is also null, then it will again return. So it will only print 0. Then we go back to this 0. Then we go to this 1. Because for every node, we go to left and we go to right. So if 1 is leaf, it will print 1. So similarly, the recursion will go here. Then it will print 0, then it will print 1. So our output should be 0, 1, 0, 1. So I made a typo, right? So, okay. So this is not what we expected. So we are calling node left and node dot right. Right, so another typo. So it is saying 10 10, which is root, right? And leaves are in same order, 0 1 0 1, right? 0 1 0 1. If I did write first, then it would print 10 10, right? So just for that test, now it should give me 10 10. So that is what we want. But now somehow I want to remember what is the path, right? So you should remember that this node will call this node and this node will call this node, right? So it seems that when we are traversing, we can pass what the previous element was, right? So let's try to do that. So I will try to pass an empty array, because for root the previous element was nothing. So right now my node, it will be called with a previous array, so it will remember what the path is, right? So if a node is null, then just return, and I will try to print previous path. Okay, so I'll call it path. So this is path from root to leaf node, because this is checking if it is a leaf node, and I'll print the path. But now I am at a node, so I need to say what the path is, right? So now whenever I'm at a particular node, so this requires some understanding of recursion. But suppose you are at this node and you already know what the path was before. So for example, if you are at this 0, the path will be 1. Now you need to add, so if you are calling this 0, now you need to append 0 to that path, right? So let's append that 0. So we will append is equal to, so we'll append this, and now you will print this new, you will pass this new path to your child. What happens here? So you started with 1, where the path was nothing, but then you came to 0, so you passed, so you came to 0, you added yourself, right? So you added your value to that path. Now 0 will remember that 1 is the path before me. So we have to add it after 1, then 0. That is correct, right? So I was just checking if you have to add it after or before. So you go to 0, the path was 1. Now you go to this 0, now the path should be 1 and 0, because you are again adding that value, right? So now if I print path, it should actually give me 10 10 101 110 and 111. So let's see, because I'm only printing path at leaf nodes. So 111, okay, because we are going right first. So I'll just change it again. So if you think about right, then it should give 111 110 101 and 100. So 111 110 101 and 10, that is what we expected, but now we have reversed it. Then it should give 100 101 110 and 111. That is 1000. That is correct, right? So we are getting paths. So now this becomes very easy. So I know that at this point I will be getting the path, and at this point I can convert that path. I can just convert that path to number, and I can just add it, right? So let me just try. I'm not sure. I'll try to do it in some. So let's say return. So instead of returning, let me add that to a global variable. But before calling this function every time, I'll have to make it 0 so that we don't mess it up. So right now I'm storing it in global. I'll also try to return it, but for ease I will just try to add it to global. Answer, I'll add to answer path to number, right? So I will pass path, and then I'll implement this function. Great, so that is done. I think this should work. So let me try something. Right, so this works. So we will use this function, which will convert a number to a decimal number if it is in base 2. So this, that is what this function is doing. So we just need to do return. We will just join that and we will return it as a base 2 number. So we will assume that this number was in base 2 and convert it to a decimal number. So this will add, keep adding answer. Let me also print it once so that we know what is happening. So we should not call this twice, but we will remove it. So let's see what all numbers are being printed. So they should be 4, 5, 6, 7. So which is correct. So our answer should also be correct, right? The numbers were 4, 5, 6, 7. So we already got the path. So the answer is undefined. Now let's see what we can do there. Answer is 0. And we are not returning it. So we have to return answer. Right? So because we were not returning anything, it was undefined. Right. So 4, 5, 6, 7 and 22, 22. I think if I submit it, it will be correct. Let me submit it and then we will improve it if we can. So this is accepted, this is correct. So I'll explain it once more. So what we did was when we are traveling from a node to the leaf. So for every leaf, we try to check. If it is a leaf, then we will do something. What we will do is like we will try to store the path. How do we store the path? We just remember what the previous path was. And in recursion, when I go to the next child, I will append this child to that path. For example, if I was at this node, then the previous path was one only. But when I go to next child, I will append this to that path, right? So for every node, I can just keep appending, right? So that way we will be able to get that path at the leaf node, and then we can just convert that path to the number. So that is what I did. So right now I'm changing a global variable. I will improve it later. Right, so that is one way. So what is happening here is like every time you are calling a recursion, you are storing an array. Right, so this is not like very simple, but it's a bit trick. So I will use a bit trick, bitwise operators, or like you can say the decimal value. So instead of passing the path, right? So what I said was like the previous number here was 1. Then there was 10. So instead of that, I can pass 10 as a binary number itself. So now what I will do is that I will say to root, I will pass only 0, right? So I will say what is the previous number. So now as I was appending previous number to the path, so what was path looking right now? 1. How, what it looks next? 10. So if my binary number was 1 and I want to convert it to 10, what do I have to do? I have to shift it by 1 and then I have to add 0, or you can actually OR as well. But let's see, right? So that is what we will do. So instead of updating the path, I will shift it by 1 and I will OR it with, right? You can add here as well because we are only working in bit right now. But let's do it this way. So this one, so updating path becomes easy. Now only one value is being stored instead of like whole array. Then we don't need to convert it to anything because it is already a number, right? For example, when it comes till here, already it will be 100, which will be 4. So I can just add that number. That is, now it is done. So that's it. So what computation we were doing here, instead we are doing it at, doing that computation at each step of recursion itself. So now we don't need to do it again. So I run it and it is giving 22, so which is correct. So what I did was instead of storing arrays, so basically earlier I was storing an array containing 10, so I at each step I converted that array to a number so that we use less memory, right? So that is done. So that is just a minor enhancement. Also, it is not a good idea to store variables in global variable, and that is only for ease of use, but I will just remove it right now and I will return some value from this DFS only. So I will return some value and now we will call it solution. can come with a better name, of course. So right, so now it has to return something. So that answer will be defined here. Right, and if node is null, I will return 0 because now we are returning numbers, right, instead of manipulating a global variable. So in competitive programming, it's okay if you use a global variable, but generally you should try to contain everything inside this so that you're not polluting the namespace. So if answer is 0, now pre is this, then answer is equals pre. If this is this. Okay, then yes. Cool. So I will explain what I'm doing. Return answer. So let me just run it once. If it runs, then I'll explain if it is correct. Right. So what we did here was so now how will it look? So now what we need to do is that I need to find out what the sum of all the leaf nodes is. So what I do is I need to find that sum at this node. I say to my left node, go and find the solution for me. I say to my right node, go and find the solution for me. Right. So basically I'm recursing. So whenever it reaches the, and obviously I'm passing the previous number, right? As I mentioned in the previous thing. So we are already passing it. So how do we do it is like, every time I ask my left child and I ask my right child and I add that to answer, right? But whenever I am at leaf node, right? So for example, if I am at this node, I need to ask my children below. But if I am already at leaf, then I don't need to ask my children. Like I will ask it just for the sake of completeness, but they will be null. But if I am a node, if I am a leaf node, then I need to add that path as well because that is the answer I need. So that is what I am doing here. If I am a leaf node, add that value of the path till now to the answer, right? Because it is 0, or I can just write plus as well, but in this case it does not matter. But so basically when I am a leaf node, I need to add the previous path, and again I ask the answers from my left and right child, right? Or if it is a leaf, I can return here as well, right? So depends on what you want to do. It will save one call. So let's run this. I hope it will give correct. Right, so it is giving correct, and let me just remove this last one node, so, or I will remove this 0 node. So it will remove 6 from our equation and the answer should be 22 minus 6, which is 16. So which is correct, right? So that is working. I was just checking that we are only exiting when both are null, right? For example, it will not exit at this node because it has only one child. It will only exit when it is at a leaf node. So that is what we will do. So let's submit it. So this is also accepted, right? So basically the main idea was that when you're recursing doing a DFS, you can store the path till the node, and how you store it is two different ways I told. One is in an array, or linked list also you can use. So, and the other way is you store that number in a decimal number because it's a binary number and you can easily convert it to a decimal number, right? So we are converting it here, right? So that is for today, and hope it was helpful. Let's see what the hint was. Yeah, cool. So that is what we have to do actually. So correct. Okay, thanks.